installing and configuring Windows Server 2012. Now this one is administering Windows Server 2012. That means after you do the installation, right? Now we have configured all the settings, right? All the basic settings are done. We have done the basic installations. Okay, now what do we have to do? We have to administer. Okay, so how do we use Windows Server 2012 for administering? Okay, that's the concept. Okay, so I think there are some 6 or 7 lessons here. Lesson is the topic, 6 lessons are there. The first lesson is about deploy, manage, and maintain servers. Okay, that is 3 parts: deployment, management, and maintenance. Okay, so what do you mean by deploy? Yeah, deploy means assign or employ, right? Okay, deploying the troops, okay, something like that. Okay, so you deploy it. So that's what it is. So you assign, you give it so that it performs. Okay, so here deployment basically means installation. Okay, deployment means installation. So it's not direct. That's what we did in the previous book, right? Installing Windows Server. So it's not installing. So deploying means not installing Windows Server, installing other things like installing clients, so client operating systems, and client softwares. Okay. So now the server is complete. Now what else you can install? You can install other things. Okay, that's in a group. Okay, inside the group. Server will manage the other installations, okay, on other computers, okay, drivers, operating systems, softwares, okay, and other clients, okay, or the members of the domain, okay, updates, okay. So that's what we have here. So we have certain roles to do that. So another role is WDS, Windows Deployment Services, okay. For deploying operating systems and softwares. It's used to automate the deployment of standard or custom images to servers. Okay, the idea is to automate, okay, the installation process. Okay, let's say you have a lot of clients. In all the clients, you want to install an operating system. Okay, so you have Windows 8. Now you want to upgrade Windows 10. And there are a lot of operating systems. So how do we do it if you don't have a server? Or in a straight, direct way, without automation. How do you do it? We go with a CD, right? And we put the CD on the computers and we boot them, we install them on every computer one by one, right? One by one. So that's the normal process. But here, since we have a server, you want to automate it. So what do? We make images of the CD. You can make images of the CD. And if you want to customize the image, means you want to customize the operating system, you can do it. Okay, that's a difficult job. Okay, means you want to change something. So when you install the operating system itself, you want certain settings. Okay, you want certain software to be there. Okay, after installation, certain software should be installed. Okay, all these things you can do. But anyway, so what do? We have an image, so that image will have everything. And we make that image, we put that image on the server. Okay, and when the clients, they restart, they boot to the network. Okay, and they find for WDS server. So when you install WDS role and you set up WDS, it becomes WDS server. Okay, just like when you configure the DHCP, it becomes DHCP server. When you configure DNS, it becomes a DNS server. Okay, it can be all in one, right? So it becomes a WDS server. So when the clients restart, they look for the WDS server, just like they look for the DHCP server, and they look what are the images available, and you can choose whatever image or whatever operating system you want to install. Okay? So the installation will happen over the network, and so does the updates and other patches and all these things. Okay, so you centrally manage the installation process or deployment process. That's the concept. Okay. So now we have to try how to do it on the VMware. Now before we do it, these are the requirements. You should have ADDS. We already have Active Directory there. Our DHCP is there. And DHCP role is available, right? We have configured DHCP. And the client should be configured for Pixie boot. You know what is Pixie boot, right? Pre-boot execution environment. Means the computer should have, the client should have the ability to boot from the network. Right? What are the devices you can boot? Normally it boots from the hard disk. That's where the operating system is. You can boot from USB, you can boot from CD, right? Similarly, there is an option for boot from network. Okay? So it will search for the WDS server or any server which has the images of the operating systems, right? For installation. DNS should be there. NTFS, that is the file system, and you should have proper credentials. That means you should be administrator. You should have the privilege to do that. Okay. Those are the things. Those things we have. That's what we have initially done all the setup. That was the first book. So we have installed the WDS role like this. Installing WDS. Deployment server, transport server. You can also use the commands, and then you have to add the images. Add images to the server. Now when it comes to images, there are different types of images. So first we will just go through a little bit of theory, and then we will go through. You see, you have boot images, install images, capture images, discover images. Okay, four types of images you can make. So images means not pictures, right? They are ISO files or BIM files, okay? Which is basically the compressed form of the operating system. The whole operating system is compressed in an image. So boot images, so they basically every when you have a CD, when operating system CD, you should have this boot image. If you don't have a boot image, then the CD is not bootable, right? You just put any CD and you cannot boot from the CD, right? The CD has to be a bootable CD. You cannot put a audio CD, video CD and boot from it, right? So it should have, so simply it should have a file called boot.bin. Okay, so that's the one which takes control and hands over to the operating system image or install image. Install.bin or actual operating systems. So install images or the actual operating systems. Capture images are used to create custom install image. Now this is something like, you know what is cloning, right? You have done cloning, right? Cloning means you have an operating system, you installed the operating system and you did all the setup. Yeah, it's like, yeah, copying the whole operating system, right? And you install the basic softwares that you need, okay? So you make a, template computer, template operating system. You want even the background, okay? Everything you change it, okay? This is how your company wants it. And then you take a copy of that. That's called capture images, okay? If it is installed images, every new system will be a fresh operating system, so you have to go manually. After installation, you have to go manually and change the names, change the wallpaper, change, install the software, you have to do everything. So what you do, you set up a computer, okay, we call it a template computer, okay, or we call it staging computer. Okay, you set up a computer, like a role model, and then you make a capture image of that. So you have an operating system, but modified operating system, customized operating system. And you install it, you deploy it on everywhere, so everyone will be uniformly, there will be uniformity in the operating systems, including background and servers. Then you have discover images used by WDS clients that do not support Pixie boot. Like if you have a client which does not support Pixie boot, then what do? You can use discover images. Okay, use boot.in from the Windows Unity tools. You have to use some tools like Windows Assessment Environment.
Thanks for that.
there is any updates, hot fixes, drivers, all these things you can make it in the operating system and you can capture the image. Okay, so basically you prepare the images and you put it in the server, and anytime you want you can do the installation on the clients. Okay, and later if you want to modify those images, like you want to add something to this image, remove something to this image, okay, that also you can do. So all those things are possible. So it's basically a new step towards automation. Okay, we'll just do the basic, very basic setup, and then let's see whether we can do advanced things. Okay. Even for doing the basic thing, I think it would take a lot of time. We have a server, right? So we need an image. It should be a bin file. Okay, let's go to the server and let's first install the role. Okay, step by step. Okay, go to manage, add roles and features. And the next. Next. Go to the role. Windows deployment services, right? Click on Windows deployment services. So that's the role we want. Next. Nothing here. Next. Next. Okay, deployment server, transport server. Huh? Transport server provides a subset of functionality in the building. It's only the core networking part. It's like a, you know, other server can be deployed, so this can just help in, you know, uploading and downloading. But we do both here. Now we need install images. Thank you.
consider it. Such a great story. Data games.
Okay, once it's installed, you will find it here in the dashboard, right? And you can right click on this. You can go for Windows Deployment Services Manager. That's what you want to do. So you have a separate area for doing deployment services, like just like every DHCP, DHCP manager, DNS manager, right? Group policy. You can also get it from tools, okay? Tools, Windows Deployment Services. Okay, so if I open the servers, Prime server, deployment server is service is not configured, so we have to configure it. So let's configure. So I can right click here, configure server. Integrated with Active Directory, yes. You want to integrate with Active Directory, yes. It's basically your choice. You want to stand alone. Next. Okay. So, this is basically the remote installation folder will contain booting where you want to put your images. Okay. So, it has to be put on the server, right? And the server has only one volume, Zebra. It doesn't have DVD. So, it recommends to make a folder in C drive remote install and put all the images in there. Just making sure, confirming you want this place to store your images. Let it be. From the change you can browse, okay? But let it be. We don't have this folder, but the folder will be automatically created. So just give next. The volume selected is also the Windows system volume. Okay, for best performance. It's not a good idea to make C drive to be the one which has the images, because whenever there is installation, all those things will go from the C drive. The downloading can happen from the C drive, and C drive is also the operating system drive, so it may slow down the server, but it's okay for us. We're not going to do that. Yes. Do not listen on DHCP, DHCP, V64, configure DHCP options. Check both because this is also a DHCP server, right? So the request, if it is coming for DHCP, don't use those requests for installation. Okay, so there may be two types of requests. One is a DHCP request, the other one is a request for WDS. Okay. So we say do not listen on DHCP ports. That's better. Next. Do not respond to any clients. You see this is fixing server, right? You can use these settings to define which client computer the server will respond to. So you can actually choose. Okay, you can be partial on which clients you want to respond to the images and which clients you don't want to respond. Right now, anyone who comes and asks for an operating system, we will give them the operating system. Okay? So no partiality. Okay? Respond to all clients, known and unknown. Okay? Require administrative approval for admin, you don't take that. No permission required, nothing. Anybody comes and asks for an operating system, we will give them the operating system. Okay? Next. Bring all files here. So in the remote install folder, there will be some files. You copy. Okay? Finish. So we have done the configuration. but there are no innies.
Tasks.
You can also start if you want. Just right click or task start. And the service will be started. So you can put install images, boot images, drivers, and many other things. But we have none now, right? So the basic thing that we can do is we can do the install images. But we need to find an image, right? Maybe a Windows 10 image, you could say. Let me find an image, okay? Windows 8. Let me see where I can get some images. Install.vim file, okay? So Vim is basically the format of Vim, Microsoft. Just like you have ISO format, you know what is ISO format, right? It's compressed version of operating systems. Just like that, you have Vim.
Okay.
macho que son también.
Yeah. let me give some
introduction.
I'm gonna be arriving.
Chapter 1. What is
all the files inside it will be extracted to a folder from the recent data and so on. Open this folder. If I go to boot, I should find boot.bin somewhere. Okay, I want install.bin right now, so it should be inside the sources.